Today is the day you will lose fat. Come see Dr. T at NJ Diet.
Easiest diet I've ever done. It's changed my life. Come see Dr. T.
Using blood work and DNA testing. 1-855-5-NJ-DIET and NJDiet.com. Change your life in only 40 days with NJ Diet.
You just said our enemies in Iraq. Did Iraq attack us?
No, I'm saying Al-Qaeda.
Okay, did Iraq attack us, Elizabeth?
Iraq did not attack us,
Correct.
Rosie. We've been there before. I'm saying our enemies, Al-Qaeda. Are you hearing that?
Not sure she misses that. Anyway, that is Elizabeth Hasselbeck arguing back and forth with Rosie O'Donnell. That became kind of the thing in 2006. She is a New York Times bestselling author. Her new book is out, Point of View, A Fresh Look at Work, Faith, and Freedom. A foreword by Candace Cameron Bure, of course, Valerie Bure's wife. And, you know, I can't help but think, as I was listening to that, Elizabeth, that today you may be on there talking about, oh, I don't know, A-Rod sexting back and forth with a porn star, or Wendy Williams, you know, drunk because her husband is having a baby with his mistress. And those may be some of the things you'd be talking about today. You don't miss that?
No, and, you know, quite honestly, and good morning. Thanks for having me.
Good morning.
Great way to start the day. and you know what I think? I think it's a great thing for women to gather at a table and to have passion about topics of the day. I don't necessarily miss the reverberation that comes with expressing your opinion in the context of, I think, our situation right now, where no matter what you say, you're guaranteed to make 100% of half the people 100% hate you. You know, so I think those numbers don't bode well for conversation. It's really why I initially felt nudged to write Point of View, because I feel like there's a way, and I know this because I did it for a decade, and I had great teachers in debate and great teachers in broadcasting. I talk a lot about, you know, whether you want behind the scenes of The View or Survivor or Fox, it's in there. But it comes with the outlook of I have my constitutional right to my opinion and my religious practices, and I should be able to hold those in this great nation that protects those freedoms and hold your hand. You know, if you don't necessarily agree with me 100%, because even the people I love, we don't agree about everything. And so I think if we can get back to that place, and certainly coming back and dipping back into this world of opinion right now, I think that it's gotten even more divided. And I think in Point of View, my goal is, like, can we get to a place where we can have discussion without discord, debate without hate, and where we can actually have more thoughtful conversations, and I didn't even think I'd be able to say this, maybe be wrong enough to get behind the lens of the person on the other side, just to see what it looks like, to see what they're seeing.
Absolutely. Elizabeth Hasselbeck, listen, it's gotten way more divided since your days on The View, as you know, as you just mentioned. And of course, again, the book is Point of View, A Fresh Look at Work, Faith, and Freedom by Elizabeth Hasselbeck. And you write, you're a person of deep faith. I mean, that permeates the book. You talk about your years as the captain of the women's softball team at Boston College. And, of course, your days on The View, where you always felt under siege. You were outnumbered, this, that, and the other. But yesterday, you were on The View, and this is getting all the headlines. Commenting on Rosie O'Donnell's comments, where she said she had a crush on you, and she engaged in a little stereotyping of female athletes. Anyway, I want to get your reaction to her response to your appearance on The View, which was, hey, Elizabeth, my crush on you was not sexual. Sorry you got scared.
So, hey, I'm not here to play ping pong with my opinion versus her response and my reaction versus her response, because I think ultimately what I said yesterday covered it. I think Rosie is a woman who is seen and known and loved by God, and I pray that He continues to pursue her, and I know He will, and I pray that she can actually have a peace, because I've seen her in her place of peace, and I've seen her with joy, and I just want that for her. And so all this in between doesn't really matter. It's insignificant. Do I believe that you cannot cast a stereotype on female athletes? Sure. Do I believe that whether your name is Rosie or Ronald and you're talking about having eyes for a woman in the workplace and taking her under your wing because of that, that it's wrong and it objectifies a woman in the workplace? Yes. But I don't believe it without having a grace in my heart, because I've been given grace and I'm so imperfect. And I have that deep faith that I mentioned, because without it, I am a jerk. And so I have to go through my days like knowing that grace comes first, not without the truth, but with grace, it looks a lot different. And so I just hope that we can get to a better place, and be just civil and kind and friends, and and that she can have a piece, because ultimately I want that for her.
I actually loved her on the show back in 2006, and I was politically more in step with you, Elizabeth, but I thought she did a very good job on that show. You know, listen.
Oh, she's so talented.
Yes, she is. Now, Bernie and I have had our disagreements over the years. We're now together about 3 years. In fact, I voted for Hillary Clinton. Now, we are in agreement today. I happen to think Donald Trump is doing a good job, but we've had some real back and forth on this show. I will tell you this. It's always followed by a laugh 5 minutes later, and we have never, ever, ever taken any animosity or differences outside of the studio. I can't imagine you can say the same. This must have really bothered you even when you left the ABC studios.
Honestly, I think that here's one thing that I think mischaracterizes the view, is that because it's women, we seem like we must hate each other, right? Of course it's a catfight. Of course we're punching. Of course we're getting at each other. It's not the case. Joy and I have had over a decade-long friendship. Whoopi Goldberg and I were texting this morning.
Wow.
We love each other so well, but we don't think a lick alike, but we love each other the same. And I do think that there is something when you do The View for that long, you know you have to come back. It operates like a family. Like, we're all coming back for dinner. Like, we're coming back tomorrow. We're going to see you again at lunch. So I think the two of you are actually expressing what totally happens at The View, but I think for whatever reason, and maybe it's because it's women at the table, I think it's a great thing that women have passion about these issues. Now, does it get misplayed sometimes as having catfights and punch fests and boxing ring? Sure. Are the best things in life oftentimes met with challenge? Absolutely. Listen, I talk about it in the book, like standing on a rock for 8.5 hours, what the process to get on Survivor was like. Like, all those things were super hard. Never want to try to jump out of a plane again. Like,
no, that was
never.
Very difficult. But I would say, we're talking with Elizabeth Hasselbeck on the Bernie and Sid Show on WABC. The book is called Point of View. And again, I mentioned the faith permeates your book. Now, you were really upset when you were informed that they weren't going to renew your contract. And you went to a man who you didn't really know. You met him once, maybe, or some encounter, Roger Ailes, and he hired you to go to Fox and Friends, and that was an ordeal in itself, too. The hours were terrible for you, and faith got you through all of that.
Well, it sure did, and let me tell you what else did. A great mentor who stepped down and gave me a recommendation. When you say not renewed contract, you're so kind to put it that way. I'll be blunt. I was fired. Fired.
Yeah.
I think, and that's where just TV talk, but we're going to fire you in the future. Like, that contract you think you have, that promise you think you have, we're not doing that. So I think we all know what that means. And I think that was really hard for me because I'm a hard worker and I have a walk-on mentality. I'm like, what can I do to make it better? Like, all I wanted to know was, how do I get this back? And the truth of the matter was, Barbara Walters is my ultimate mentor for 10 years, PhD in broadcasting. I write a ton about her because I've never been more grateful for a woman in broadcasting who's done more for women in broadcasting and more for this woman. She called Roger. She reached out to Roger right away and was like, hire her.
Yeah,
and
I read
so without,
that.
Without that, I would have never had that job.
Wow.
Now that job, listen, you know, you talk about great coaches all the time, right? Like, who's your favorite coach?
Casey Stengel.
There you go. Bill Belichick.
Let's talk Belichick. This is perfect. Do you think Belichick is hard on his players? Do you think he grinds them to get the most out of them?
I've been hurt. He's been described as a prick, to be honest, Elizabeth.
Well, yeah, okay, well.
Pardon the language.
See, I would not choose those words. Or my coaches. I can respect, I can both have a hard day with my mentor and understand that they are refining those around them by their expectations. And listen, does that go wrong? Sometimes, absolutely. I'm not talking about abusive situations in the workplace. I'm not talking about objectification of women in the workplace. I'm not talking about abusive language and demeaning someone in the workplace, whether it's on the football field or whether it's in finance. But I do believe fully that I had the chance to work for one of the greatest coaches. Mm. And so when I got to Fox and had that job, I had the greatest team. So I've had a lot of privilege in terms of the workplace. I just mismanaged my clock. Like, if Belichick mismanages his minutes on the field, it doesn't go well. So for me, I mismanaged my minutes at Fox where I wasn't getting ample rest. And so I couldn't even accelerate in this new area, which I already felt unqualified for, you know, beyond.
Well, you were good.
You were good.
I know
it was
tough for you. But
by the way, we're also big fans of your husband, Tim, giant fans here, an ESPN football fan. So I know you married 17 years. He's a great guy. So congratulations on that, too.
Oh, my gosh. He's the best. Like, I really, he holds me up in all these situations. He has just kind of been this, well, absolutely been like a steady rock for me.
Yeah.
And so encouraging too, like wildly protective of me, but at the same time knows that I have this sort of like, let's try this part of me. And so whether it's a job or trying to jump on a plane or throw myself in the Australian outback or going on The View or taking a morning job at Fox, like it just, he's always been there for me. I think the easiest way to be, for me, the woman that I can be is because I've got a guy like him. Like, I don't deny that. I've got a great God, and I've got an awesome guy.
And you make like, you make that abundantly clear in the book, Elizabeth Hasselbeck, which is called Point of View, A Fresh Look at Work, Faith, and Freedom. Listen, go buy the book, folks. It's inspirational. And, Elizabeth, we wish you Godspeed and all the best. Thank you very much.
So I'll see everybody at Books and Greetings tonight, 7 p.m.
Books and Greetings. Oh, what town is that?
Come see me. It's right in New Jersey in Livingston. Books
yes.
and Greetings.
Yes.
Right, if you, hey, I will bring pizza if you're there. For the
beautiful. Books and Greetings in Livingston, New Jersey
That's
tonight.
A great bookstore.
How
great
do you like
bookstore.
That? Okay, we'll
congratulations.
Come and see you.
All righty. Thank you, Elizabeth.
Thanks.
All right. Take care. That's Elizabeth Hasselbeck. Don't forget, Newt Gingrich is going to stop by momentarily. Talk more about the Mueller report. Back on Bernie and Sid right after this.
Bernie and Sid in the morning.